finished as strong as anybody on this Stonybrook team.
Brings a lot of energy, you know. At this level, a lot of people want to see bigs score, and that's hard to find at this level. I mean, the Jameel Warneys, you know, those types of guys don't come along very often. But what Jacob brings is a lot of work, a lot of effort, and intensity, and his teammates feed off of that.
Coley is off the mark. Battle there with Travis Fuller, but it was taken down by number 22, Brian Secunda, senior from State College, PA. He's got the rock right now. Here's Michael Almonacy, the sophomore from right here on Long Island from Brentwood High School.
Brown extending the defense there, really getting out on the shooters because a couple of them for the Seawolves have some range.
Oh, dribble drive going high off the window. Erekbu.
And see, that's what I think makes the difference in Erekbu's game, because a gunner, he can fire it up from the outside. But now, when you make yourself have to be defended on the perimeter, that defender has to come a step, and he's quick enough to get by.
Whistle on the drive by Zach Hunsaker, away from the ball. Double doubles, and that's one of the reasons that jersey number 20 is hanging up there.
Absolutely.
Good entry, swatted away.
Good defense by the
Seawolves. Soph couldn't get it up there in time.
Three Seawolves converging and contesting that shot.
Petrus on the block. Flipped it up. Rebound Fuller, a 6'9 junior from Encinitas, California. High rebound there, and here comes Almonacy. It'll be interesting to see Almonacy from freshman to sophomore, how much he has matured, and if his game from high school really comes back in his sophomore season.
Well, I like his handle, and I like the fact that he knows how to run a team. I think what's suffering right now is just his offensive confidence.
Secunda took down the air ball from the weak side, and it's inside. Then on the putback, Olani, he's got five.
Hey, you got to know how to score, and part of knowing how to score is the head fake. Just he head faked twice, throws the defenders, and then able to get up quickly and outscore them. Just savvy moves around the rim.
You know something when you talk about a head fake, Kirk? Obi Okoli with a left-hand runner did not go. And then coming down with the rebound was Okoli again. The head fake, and we'll talk about it when we come back. Timeout on the court. Stony Brook with a five-point lead.
The Brown coming into tonight.
Yes.
A four-game span. That's a lot of shots.
He had a lot of time coming off the sitting on the train. He was hour and 40 minute train ride, I guess. But he's coming up with stuff that makes the broadcast oh so good. Off the mark, good position there. And because Fuller was in front, Petrus had to climb over the back.
Contact there. But when you're 6'11", 250, you're not going to get the benefit of the call a lot of the time.
A name that might be familiar to basketball fans, freshman number 35 to Stonybrook, Anthony Pacheco. We've heard that name, maybe Villanova? And that's a nice little runner going glass. Is Hunsaker, one of the tri-captains. He's got five.
Villanova in action today, turned away, I believe, Western Kentucky by about 6 or 8 points. It was a tightly contested affair, but yeah, national championship in that family.
Yep. Here's Secunda. It's a one-point game. It's been a beauty. 10 minutes in. Secunda launches three.
And that's why the Seawolves can take those threes. We got people like Erekbu and Secunda, who was dialed in from the get-go against UConn, where he just came out and stroked his first three, and they were from deep. And with that 6'6 frame, Carl, he can shoot over anybody.
Kurt, we talked about the fluidity of this game. When you don't have turnovers, as Howard looks for three and short rebound pull by Fuller. Stonybrook only one. Brown with only three. Triple drive there by Jason Massey. We've got a tie-up. Possession arrow will stay with Brown. Turnovers, clean, crisp basketball.
How about the pace of this game? Remember back in the day when Ivy was walking up the floor and it was back cuts? It was that Princeton offense.
Hello, Pete Carril.
Absolutely. Everybody now has some tempo. They're trying to get the ball up the floor, get the matchups that they want. And this is an athletic type of game.
Trying to create. This is Chris Sullivan, who drops a three. Sullivan, a junior from Wilmette, Illinois. First 3 points. His brother, Peter, and Matthew, all Ivy and Brown in 2011 and 2013, and both scored 1,000 points. So he's the third playing the Brown.
And what sets up that play is just the old school post-up opportunity. Two tempo dribbles and a ball reversal, and you find a wide open three shooter.
Tend to shoot. It's Michael Almonacy. It is number two.
So again, look at that. Almonacy not thinking out there, just more into a mode of knowing the offense, knowing what's needed of him, and just catches a wide open shot. Again, off a nice reversal. Little diagonal pass.
Great inside position there by Junior St. Pell on the rebound. Might have forced it, able to recover, gets it to Secunda. Plenty of time, 8.5 left in the half, and 15 now to shoot. True contact, Eric Boo. Might have altered the shot, fought for. Possession arrow in favor.
I mean, he can play above the rim, and that's not cliche. But put on 20-plus pounds of muscle in the offseason, and really thinks though, Maryland, David Erebor,
talented front court player for the Brown Bears, who are very, very young, Kurt. 5 freshmen, 4 sophs, 3 juniors, only 1 senior. Almonacy was feeling it. St. Tell went high, and he'll get called for over the top on the rebound.
Not quite as top
6-5 on the young season from the free throw line. Hip surgery. So you have to hope that he comes back healthy next year and he'll have his 3 years. You can leave school and get 4, but in the Ivy League, there's no red shirt. So he'll be out this year, and then he'll play his final 3 years.
Right. No medical red shirts.
No red shirt, period.
Right. And no playing as a grad either.
Driving inside there. That was a beauty by Kwasi Yeboah. He's got 10 points now. Double digits. Game's high scorer.
You and I both liked his game last year as a freshman. And then he played internationally over the summer, and I think he added some consistency to his game. He can post up, he can score from the outside, and he's gotten stronger.
That was a very quick catch and shoot by David Erebor, the sophomore. He's a face-up guy, but can also back up to the basket as well. So multi-talented offensively away from the ball. There is a whistle and a foul, timeout on the court. And back with more on ESPN3 right after this timeout. Stay with us.
Basketball is a shared game. And how do you do it? You share it by moving the basketball against the zone. You saw the skip pass from Brian Secunda and a wide open Michael Almonacy knocks down the three. And that's just moving the ball. The man cannot move as fast as the basketball. And you're sharing the ball. Everybody's getting a touch. And then you're capping it with a nice wide open perimeter shot in the heart. It's psychological because you know, hey, each teammate is looking for the other, and if you're open, you stand a great chance of getting the basketball. It's not ISO basketball where people stand around looking at one dynamic player doing his thing. They are sharing the game.
So Jeff will miss the front end of the 1-1. So the score holds. Brown with a chance for a tie. Perhaps take the lead here on this possession. Knocked out of the hand. For Stonybrook. 21 to shoot for Brown. Olivia Coley on the inbound, got it to Fuller. Trying to back his way in, went up with the left hand, and Fuller starting to feel it. Down low, he's got 5.
Well, really just muscled up. I mean, he got those 2 tempo dribbles and got himself deep in the paint, and then a nice finish with the left hand.
Michael Almonacy is being guarded there by his opposite number, Brandon Anderson, and a good, tough, strong drive by Sturdivant, able to draw the contact, and he'll go to the line for 2 shots, 12 points a game.
Out here at the Allen Federal Credit Union Arena, getting a little restless. You know, they don't realize Brown's got game. They can score, and they have been on the road. And now they're kind of settling in, if you will.
Third straight game on the road for Brown. Longest stretch on the road until they get to February when they'll play 4 straight in the Ivy League on the road. That is short. Air ball. We've got a bounce.
But it's a bad post-entry pass, Carl, if you pull your guy off his position. Fuller had great position on the block, and that lazy attempt at a pass really pulled him three steps out, forced him to take a jumper instead of that post-up move where we've seen him be so effective.
Greg Boot for three. Off the front iron. Looking Sturdivant go down, but it's Anderson who comes up with the basketball. Dribbles through traffic and gives it up to Show, number 25.
Good transition defense, though, by Stonybrook getting back.
Away from the ball.
You know, again, the big man, he wants those touches and allowing his frustration to get the best of him. And as a junior, he needs to be the leader and sort of not take those type of bad fouls.
He's replaced by number 44, Matt DeWolf, the freshman. To his left, tough defense there by Akoli. Here's Anderson on a leak-out pull-up. Battle for it, last touch by Michael Almonacy.
So even though if you're scouting the Seawolves, you say they take a lot of three-shoot shots that aren't in your comfort zone.
Here's Chris Sullivan back on the floor, number 11 for Brown. Huntsicker. Fake, dribble drive, loose. They're playing football and rugby. Numbers are there. They try to shovel it, looking for a Sturdivant. And
he's got to throw a bounce pass. Can't go air to air and have a deflection.
They get it to Sturdivant. Protects and gives to Almonacy with a runner. Joshua Howard flying through. And here's Zach Huntsinger.
I like to see Almonacy taking that type of shot, though. Using that handle to get inside the defense.
Joshua Howard is watched by Sikonda. Here's Sturdivant off the steal. Working on DeWolf. Step through. Left hand.
That's a nice finish. And you see an example there, although he's a big, not playing above the rim, but knowing how to use his body.
Coming right back. Got a blocking foul. Akoli was going hard to the basket. And he was fouled by Sturdivant. Timeout on the floor. What a ball game. Stony Brook by two. College basketball on ESPN3. First action, one of the captains. And
if you look at the rebounding numbers, he's got goose eggs. No offensive rebounds, no defensive rebounds, which means no rebounds. That's not a good number for him. He's got to be involved in that cleaning of the glass. He was an integral part of it last year, and that can't change that dramatically this year.
Tied at 50. 11.5 remaining second half. Almonacy loops it down low baseline. Kick out. Here's Cornish back in. On to three. Yeah,
shot. Well
high.
Contested right
yeah,
there.
It was.
And you see what Brown did. Took it out of the post. No opportunity for the Seawolves bigs to really get at the rim. They forced that reversal out and forced the Seawolves into a contested perimeter shot.
Huntsinger looking for an opening. Got it out. Howard, got a screen from Howard, continues the dribble drive, and it did not drop, and there's a whistle, and they'll stay on the ground end of the floor. 4 of 4 on the strike. Friend, you can treat him, do whatever you want. He's not getting it. 7 on 1 of 2. Here's Desmond Cambridge. Okay, 1946 football season for Brown. He was an assistant coach. 1946, same season into 47. 1 year as the Brown head coach of basketball, and he went 8-12. Who is this very, very famous man?
Well, I know there are a couple of football alums. This is not them, but Bill O'Brien, head coach of the Texans, is
1946.
That. 1946. Right. And Joe Paterno, class of 50. But I'm going to take a stretch here because I just know that he attended the university. John Heisman?
No.
You
ready for this?
Yes.
All right, let me just set it here with Matt DeWolf on offense. Giving you a little bit more time. A little catch and shoot there. And it goes out of bounds. And it was saved. And Almonacy with a good heads up to St. Kell. Contact. Offensive foul. And Jeff Bold is hot.
Thought that the defender got back and established himself. I think it's the toughest call in college basketball, bang, bang. But I really thought the defender made a great effort to hustle and establish just long enough.
Just can't buy one from the outside. Almonacy gives it quickly up to corners. Here's St. Tell. thought about it, and they'll reset the offense. Shot clock with 20. Almonacy to the corner to St. Kelly. Dribble drive, opening, and we'll shoot free throws this time. The Baltimore Colts.
Wow.
Steve Eubanks.
How about that? That just shows you. Born to coach.
Well, 100%. Two of two from the line for St. Kel. And Stony Brook on top by three. By the way, ESPN 3 telecast. One of the great alums from Brown in class of 77, Chris Berman.
Yes.
The president of the United States. We got a good one here. We're going to keep going with this basketball game. Brown down by three with a chance to tie here. Dribble and a drive, and it's a good drive there by Sullivan. But another foul.
John D. Rockefeller is an alum. Now, John D. Rockefeller is the sole patron.
Now we're going to confirm. They call Brandon Cruz, and they blow it, they change it, and it's coming Stony Brook.
And that's good officiating
right there.
Because the crowd reacts to the initial call, but it's all about, that's why you have three guys on the floor, and they get together. There's no egos involved. They communicate, and it's like, hey, I have the better angle. I'm going to make the call, which was the right call. So they get it right, which is what you want as a group.
100%. Secunda. Oh, that's sweet off the dribble.
That's a tough shot, Carl, but you're still down to five. And it caused some foul trouble. Now, Brown, what they have done very, very well is put a couple of people from Stony Brook in foul trouble, and they are key figures, St. Tell and Sturdivant, now both, I think, with four.
Yes.
And that is something that the Seawolves don't want to have to endure.
Off the hesitation, Anderson went up. It was blocked by Cornish. They run the floor and swat it away by Desmond Avery.
It goes to reason that you can get up. He says, get that shot out of here.
Cornish and the foul!
Now Cornish comes back and he sees his teammate having gotten the shot blocked, and he says, you know what? I'm going to go left hand, keep my body, and I'm not going to suffer the same thing. Very nicely done.
This free throw shows on the rebound. Down by seven, 8.5 remaining. Round with the basketball trailing. Here's Hunziker. Turnaround again by Cambridge. It was short. Cornish draws contact, and he'll go right back to the free throw line.
Rather than go for a reach that isn't going to pay quality minutes, and they use a three-guard rotation at that point guard position. We've seen McKenzie, we've seen Almonacy, now we've seen Cornish. Cornish has been effective.
Matches the largest lead of the game. Second time Stony Brook has led by as many as nine. Did so in the first half as well. DeWolf lost his footing, somehow able to get the pass off, and then the runner going class, Hunziker, third field goal, he's got seven.
Came right in, we've seen him drive it to the rim a couple of times, and I always like when players remember what that box is for and use it off the glass there for the nice finish. Sturdivant, by the way, struggling from the free throw line, cost 7 of 12.
Not struggling is Brian Secund, the fourth field goal, he's got 10.
Taking those days. He used to be an exclusively sit on the perimeter outside the arc, knock down those, but off the dribble now. Second jumper that we've seen inside and on the move. Tough to defend.
His first two baskets of the night with triples. His last two are of the regular variety. But as you said, off the dribble, which was really in this first half, Stony Brook by nine once again.
That was a nice and one and a big bucket when the Seawolves needed it again in trying to stave off Brown, and you see him getting the accolades from his teammates as they get on the floor.
And what I like, he's not afraid to go in amongst the land of the Giants with that. He had that deep problem in first action, so he must feel full throttle to go inside and have 100% mental ability to not worry about that leg anymore.
Right, and that's a big thing, Carl. When you can just play carefree like that, that kind of injury, that tells you a lot about the player and how they're feeling.
Hunziker with a high arcing three, second of the game. He's got 10. beat cut to six.
You can tell about how he's feeling about the game. I mean, that was over Secunda. He got a good closeout, and at 6-6, he had to put it up. But sometimes when a guy is in your face, you actually shoot it better because you get that arc.
That was a high arcer, but it was pulled down by Cho. And the Brown Bears once again on the attack with Hunsaker. Hit the back of the iron, but how about Travis Fuller back on the floor playing with four, and is still attacking the offensive window.
Yeah, been so active and has four offensive rebounds today.
And that's 16 offensive rebounds.
The highest number of rebounds garnered by a Seawolf individually with Kwasi Yeboah with four.
We have 10 different players that have snatched a rebound and fully goes to the line. He's 5 of 6, he's got 7 points. Right there. And so the rest of the way, we are guaranteed 1 and 1. Get the second free throw automatically when you have 10 fouls.
And you saw a guy like Coley off to a fast start at the free throw line and then missed
his first four. Yeah.
Right, missed two of his last three. So free throws down the stretch in a game like this now become critical.
Oh, yeah.
See Brown in that zone, 2-3, just really extending it out. Seagulls, be patient, good ball reversal.
Monacy is short. Akoli wants to push, gets the ball up. Top and missing there was Desmond. Has high expectations even with this young team. He's very excited. He said because the future is so bright. That free throw is missed by Jacob Petras. And we'll come back at the other end in a 6-point game, 5:45 left.
You know, they understand the talent that they have, meaning the individual player. But they've got to understand how to fit that within the framework of a team concept.
Step back, has had trouble shooting. Just hasn't really gotten a rhythm in Zach Hunsaker in this game.
Yeah, he's hit some big shots, but hasn't strung together the run that you know he's capable of. But again, they don't lack for effort on that defensive end.
Now, Monacy got the step on a kick out to Arecu. Olani off the mark. Elijah Olani from Newark, New Jersey, again off the bench with 11 and 10 straight, getting 16 off the bench against Michigan State in the last game. Doing it again today, less than 5 minutes remaining.
Red zone causing problems for the Seawolves offensively, but Brown not doing it on the offensive end themselves.
Stripped Hunsaker, and then tried to save it, but he did foul Almonacy. And it's a hold, and we'll get two shots. Michael Almonacy to the free throw line on the season. He is a perfect 2 for 2 in this contest. He's got 5 points.
Now, this is a big opportunity for this young man. Because you know what, at this level, Carl, he's not going to wow you with his athleticism. He doesn't have great length. But the cliche of knowing how to play, as you saw him there, he took the ball right to the defender and forced the defender to put a foul on him. And if he can go to the line and do what he just did, knock down free throws in a critical time, that scores points for coaches. Because you know what? You can't teach that. You can practice free throws all you want. But can you knock them down when your team needs it?
Pun intended, scores points.
Yeah.
Right? On two different plateaus.
Yes. How many games have you seen in your extensive career, Carl, where guys can score games, score points, but then when it comes down to the final 2 minutes, the final 4 minutes, they don't want to be at the free throw line?
That's the guy that doesn't want the ball at the end of the game, regardless of if he's shooting or not. Hey, Petras on the block there of Travis Fuller.
I don't know if he got credited with the first one when he was on the ground, but the second block, and again, that's what he does, has that presence there and provides a little leadership and toughness inside.
Now he's calling for the ball. He knows Fuller has the four personal, so it's smart by Petras to call as Cambridge comes back in, along with Howard for Brown. We've got 4 minutes and 10 seconds left, and Brown's got to hurry. Been down by 8.
Yeah, you know, I mean, Jacob mishandled that there. And the expectation for a big man is always big. It's always outsized. They always think, if I was your height, I would do this. It's not that easy, but you got to love the effort that Petras gives. How about that effort right there?
Oh, and the foul for Brandon Anderson.
How good's Brown's defense been overall, though? The Seawolves were 7 of 15 in the first half from three-point range. They are 0 for 7 in this half from beyond the arc.
Anderson is now 3 of 3 from the line. He's got 12 points, 5-point game, less than 4 remaining. Here we go with Michael Almonacy.
Again, meaningful minutes for a guy coming off your bench, and we've seen 3 point guards here today.
Sunday gave it up. Yeboah inside, playing with 4. Going high off the window, second field goal. Tyrell Sturtevant able to cash home.
Look, shooting threes are nice, and if you can add that to your skill set, that's great. But as a senior, getting those tough must-have buckets inside, got to be a part of your odds.
Trying to make something happen.
That was a no-look blind pass, and he was fortunate that he didn't commit a crucial turnover.
Brandon Anderson tried to cash in 3, did not get it. Sekunda chased it down and protecting the backboard, and gives to UC or Ekbu, and now to Michael Almonacy, and then they return. And
good
catch.
Good officiating there. It was a little physical in chasing that loose ball. No advantage had by either side, and the officials let him sort it out. Let the players decide the outcome.
No harm, no foul. Yeboah for 3. High bounce, and it drops down. His third triple. He's got 13. Stony Brook with its largest lead of 10.
They don't have Thanksgiving in England, but they got home cooking. There's a jumper, and of course, as his head coach has acknowledged, can also be a factor in the post-up game.
You might have to get rapid fire here from the arc, down by 10 with 2:35 left, but Anderson goes inside and is able to stop the clock.
Stopping the clock.
That's hot here. It's 98 degrees.
look at Carl. He knows the stuff.
Showing some stuff here.
This guy
rimmed out.
He's got game. But you mentioned stopping the clock. Seawolves can't do that. They don't want to commit fouls and give Brown an opportunity to really extend that game.
Bring a whole repertoire of music on Sunday.
How about that?
Yeah.
I would have lost that bet.
That I would have come up with 98 degrees here on a Good Morning America.
They.
Oh, blocked beautifully there by Cambridge.
Now, I mean, what have I been talking about with Sekunda all game long? 6'6", can shoot it over anybody, except maybe Cambridge.
The best dunker in New Jersey, which means you have hops.
Great closeout. He's not far. Did not allow Sekunda to gain separation, and then gets a big block.
Off the inbound at Sturtevant. Here's Almonacy. Eric D's right there. Brandon Anderson is all over him. 3 to shoot. Eric Boo!
Yeah, that's just too hot to handle right there for young Mr. Hunsicker. Because that's a senior, albeit smaller, but so much more explosive. And the ability to play above or at the rim makes him a great finisher.
Oh, splash on a 3 by Cambridge, his 3rd of the game. He's got 17 points.
Yeah, but Mike Martin, you know, as a Brown alum, he is invested in the job.
100%. A steal. Cambridge missed. Almonacy got it. And now the sophomore Almonacy, we will walk it back. That's the 9th foul, team foul on Brown. So we'll shoot 1-1 with Almonacy, who's 2 for 2 in this contest. The sophomore played for Brentwood High School, the Brentwood Indians. And now let's see what he can do here. This was a take-charge guy, as good a player there was on Long Island when he played at Brentwood.
They put up some incredible career numbers.
You would say stupid numbers
at
times.
And in the past, a legend in Mitch Kupchak, formerly of the Lakers and the Lakers' former general manager, who was a standout at Brentwood. And, I mean, like you said, the numbers are just stupid.
And Kupchak played for the late, great Stan Kellner. I did a lot of high school games over the years. In fact, I don't know, 5, 6, 7 years ago, they named the court at Brentwood Stan Kellner Court. Almonacy drops 2 of 2. Anthony Jimenez was his high school coach. Michael Almonacy, a great guy as well. 11-point lead now on the made free throws, and they're going to have to hustle and throw them up. That one did not go. Almonacy gets it to Petrus.
And look at that. Goes under and digs out a rebound that wasn't even really his to be had. Head coach, as you talk about Mr. Almonacy, is head coach from high school. in the stands tonight.
Here tonight, yeah. I'd like to find him after the game because he is an unbelievable teacher in the classroom as well as the basketball court at Brentwood. And we've got a timeout. 109 remaining and an 11-point lead for Stony Brook. What would be the Madison Square Garden of College, the Palestra in Philadelphia. I had the chance to do an Ivy League championship game, the play-in game, Harvard and Yale 2 years ago, 3 years ago when Harvard won 53-51. It's an unbelievable place to go watch college basketball.
I've not checked that off.
Oh, you've got to go, Kurt. You've got to visit the Palestra in Philly. Howard for three, went high off the window. Almonacy going high, and he'll go to the line. 10th team foul. He's going to shoot two. Michael Almonacy has taken this game over in the last few minutes.
Right, and he's done so with just knowing how to play. Good players, what do you always say, Carl? Good players find ways to make plays. I'm paraphrasing you.
No,
but
big-time players and big-time games will make a big-time play.
And these don't look spectacular. They're not dunks. They're not a barrage of threes. But ask his teammates, ask his coach how valuable these free throws have been down the stretch.
5 for 5 right now in this contest on the free throw. And coach for all the time, Chris Hump, sports information guy for Brown, been there 100 years, knew when he was down here on Long Island, 2 of 2. He's got 11, 13-point game. Mike Martin's got about 10 of these guys coming tomorrow for Thanksgiving dinner to his house. A lot of college coaches do that because the kids really can't go home as Hunter can knock that one down.
Part of the sacrifice. Yeah. That fans don't really appreciate what these guys go through.
I'm sure Jeff Bowles might have a few guys coming over to his house as well. I know Jay Wright has had people over at Thanksgiving and Christmas in his years down in Villanova. His wife, Patty, they host everybody. Well, what separates him is Almonacy goes back to the line for two more. And he's just cannon free throws right now. He's now 7 for 7. He's got the ring.
Yes. And you know what? There are guys that you root for to get that, and you root it for him because he's one of college basketball's good guys.
Has not forgotten where he started.
Not
same guy as the guy that I met 1993, so that's almost 25 years ago. Count down to seconds. This is going to be a Stony Brook win here, Kurt. A well-deserved win, one that they really needed to have in the first game of the season here at home.
Yeah, it validates, hey, we needed to get back home. Tough schedule on the road, and they come home and find a way to gut it out.
77-64, Stony Brook over Brown. We're back with the coach after this.